Let's say you've got Silly Tavern up and running, and everything is good, but you want more. You want it to generate images of your adventures. And maybe you've asked around, but you don't have quite the help you're looking for.
Help, computer.
I don't know much about computers other than the one we got at my house.
In this guide, I'll get you up and running with all the basics of Stable Diffusion integration. I'm going to assume that you already have Silly Tavern up and running and that you can generate text. Getting to that point is a tutorial for another day. But assuming that you can type and the character responds, that's all you need to get started here. Let's start with our character Serafina, which, as of recording this, is a default character that comes with Silly Tavern. She's very good for testing out your setup. So what we'll do is go over to the extensions in the top right and go to Image Generation Settings. Here you'll see different options for the source, including Automatic 1111, Comfy UI, Novel AI, etc. Now, if you don't know where to start, I would start with Automatic 1111 or the newer Forge UI, which is a fork of Automatic 1111, works basically the same. They both have one-click installers, just run webui.bat or .sh, depending on your Windows or Linux, and you should be up and running very easily. The only thing you need to do is, on your webui user file, make sure you have enabled the command line option --api. This will enable Silly Tavern to communicate with the Stable Diffusion web UI. You do not have to have the web page open for this to work. Silly Tavern will just use this in the background as long as it's running. Now, all you have to do is click Connect, and it should give you an indicator that it is connected successfully. If everything is connected, you should be able to click the little wand icon at the bottom, and there will be an option to generate image. That means everything works so far. But before we generate our first image, there are a few more things to configure. First, the resolution of the image you generate, keeping in mind that bigger images take more time, naturally. I recommend using one of these pre-configured resolutions. If your model is Stable Diffusion 1.5 based, try 512 by 768. And if you're using Stable Diffusion XL, try out 896 by 1152. The next thing you'll want to do is create a style preset. This allows you to add things to the positive prompt and negative prompt for every image that is generated. This is going to be specific to the model that you're using or to a style that you want to have for that session. And what I've done here is add nothing in the positive prompt and use my favorite negative prompt for this model, which is Base68 for Stable Diffusion 1.5. I'm not going to dwell on the exact stuff that you put in here, because it's going to vary from model to model. Just be aware that you can set it here. With all that stuff out of the way, we can now focus on the prompt templates. It does come with a default prompt template, but you may want to tweak it. These templates are what are sent to the language model to ask it to make a Stable Diffusion prompt. Silly Tavern then forwards that information onto Stable Diffusion to generate an image. Stable Diffusion then processes that input and gives the image back to Silly Tavern. So let's see what this instruction is. In the next response, I want you to provide only a detailed, comma-delimited list of keywords and phrases which describe character. The list must include all of the following items in this order: name, species, race, gender, age, clothing, occupation, physical features, and appearances. Do not include descriptions of non-visual qualities, blah, blah, blah. Include adjectives describing most recent actions. Do not write in full sentences. Only provide descriptors and adjectives in a comma-delimited list. So let's see how this instruction works. Go down to the magic wand, click Generate Image of Yourself, and yourself meaning the character we're talking to. You'll have to wait a little bit for the language model to respond, and then you'll have to wait some more for Stable Diffusion to create the image. And then it will pop up right here in the chat. So there we go, that's not half bad. Let's take a look at the command line and see what happened under the hood. So let's read off what it sent. Serafina Faye, supernatural female, mid-20s, black sundress, guardian, pink hair, long hair, amber eyes, white teeth, pink lips, white skin, soft skin, graceful, empathetic, serene, strong, perceptive, healing magic, protective magic, nature magic, butterflies, ethereal aura. And of course, there's the manually input negative prompt that we specified earlier. Now, a human probably wouldn't put stuff in there like perceptive and healing magic and stuff like that, but the results speak for themselves. It's pretty good. But now let me show you something interesting. I'm going to go over to Ooba Booba and change the language model from something that is pretty good and follows instructions pretty well to something that's more verbose but tends to follow instructions a little more loosely. Just going to type a message just to make sure it's responding. All right, that looks good. Now let's generate an image. Let's pop on over to the command line and see what it sent to Stable Diffusion. Okay, interesting. First of all, it's not just a comma-delimited list of features like the other model. It's kind of giving a profile thing, and it's typing in full sentences, which we told it explicitly not to do. Now, if we go and look at what it generated, it still looks like the character, though it did have enough information to work off of, but all of that flowery language in full sentences were kind of not necessary for Stable Diffusion, so the information there is less dense. You can fit less details in for a prompt. That's not necessarily a problem for this one image of her just standing there, but it could be a problem when there's multiple characters in the scene or something's going on, some kind of action. All right, let's change the prompt template and see if we can get it to say things in a different way. Pause your roleplay and provide a brief description of character, including hair color, clothes, eye color, facial features. Do not include any non-visible characteristics like personality or thoughts. Keep the description brief to concise sentences. Okay, now that we've got that modified instruction, let's see what that does. Description. Serafina is a young woman with long pink hair that flows down to her waist. She wears a black sundress adorned with delicate white flowers and has amber eyes that seem to glow with inner light. Her skin is as pale as porcelain, contrasting beautifully against the vibrant hues of her attire. Her face is angelic, framed by rosy cheeks and soft pink lips. Resume your role play with Serafina's description in mind. All right, that's not exactly concise, and it also seems to be trying to reply with instructions for me, like resume my role play. And we don't really want that in our prompt, but let's take a look at what it generated. All right, she's still got pink hair, yo eyes, and a black dress. Her hair is not long. It seems like that roundabout description of the length of her hair was not good for Stable Diffusion. But all things considered, you could probably still work with this. All right, now for the sake of completion, let's switch back to the first model that followed our instructions a little bit more literally. And let's see how it does with these modified instructions. Serafina has pink hair which shimmers in the sunlight, framing her serene face with a touch of mystique. Her attire consists of a simple black sundress that flows gracefully around her slender figure, adorned with delicate vine patches. Her eyes, the hue of rich amber, hold an infinite depth of compassion and wisdom. The lines of her face suggest both strength and gentleness and blah, 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 blah. Personality, caring, protective, compassionate, healing, nurturing, blah, 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 gentle. Aha, look, towards the end there. Pink hair, amber eyes, white teeth, pink lips, white skin. There's some descriptors that'll help. Again, not as good as the very first instruction that we give it, but probably a little better than the other model. Let's take a look. Okay, she does have long hair this time, so that checks out. And honestly, everything it's done so far has been good enough. But the point here is that with a little bit of tweaking, you can drastically change what it sends to Stable Diffusion. So if you get some really weird results, just keep in mind that it's not set in stone. You can change the instructions that you give it.
それからどうしたの?
Transition. By the way, it's not that important which models I'm using for this. But in case you're curious, the first model was Kunoichi 7B. And the second model was Estopian Maid 13B. I used GPTQ quantizations that were provided by the bloke. Kunoichi 7B is capable of running on about 8 gigabytes of RAM or VRAM, and Estopian Maid 13B about 12 gigabytes. And I have a GPU with 12 gigabytes of VRAM that I'm running them on. So when it comes to running only on GPU, I can't really do anything bigger than that. Alright, with that out of the way, let's get back to Silly Tavern.
それからどうしたの?
Transition. Alright, one last thing to show you. Now that we've looked at the prompt templates, let's go back to the image generation settings and change to an XL model. I've been using this one recently. It's Anime Confetti Toon XL Confetti for You. It's a derivative of Pony Diffusion, so it has those same quirks when it comes to style prompting. You'll see what I mean in a minute. I've gone back to using the initial prompt template that we used and the initial model, Kunoichi 7B. So we should get a prompt that's similar to the first image that we generated. And the only other thing I've changed is the resolution from 512x768 to 896x1152. Let's see what happens. Seraphina, magical entity, elf female, late 20s, white sundress, guardian, pink hair, amber eyes, compassionate, protective, slender physique, healing magic, gentle touch, ethereal presence. So far, so good. Let's take a look. All right, not bad, considering we haven't even done anything to be specific for this model. But I think we can do better than that. Let's modify the style settings. We'll come down here. I've got another style preset that I'm going to completely overwrite. Add in the pony-related styles. Score 9 up, score 8 up, blah, blah, blah. Change to a slightly different negative prompt that I use for this model. Then we'll save that as our new preset. Okay, let's see how this one does. As you can see, we've got our manual prompt right at the beginning, followed by the output of the language model. Very similar to the last prompt. Different negative prompt, the new thing that was specified. Let's see what that one looks like now. Yeah, that is wildly different. So, goes to show you that a little bit of tweaking goes a long way with this stuff. Now we'll do one last thing, and that's change back to the Estopian Maid 13 model, just to see what it looks like. Okay, generate image. Let's open up the command line. Okay, looks like we've got a slightly better prompt this time. Seraphina, elf, female guardian, 350 years old, black sundress, healer, ethereal appearance, long pink hair, ember eyes, white teeth, pink lips, glowing white skin, patron demeanor. But then it resumes the role play and gives me a bunch of sentences that I don't need. But does that matter? Let's find out. Very similar to the last one, and maybe even better, by some stroke of luck, perhaps. But anyway, that's all I have for you today. There are other settings that you need to tweak, like for generating different images of, like, the whole scenario and stuff like that. But it's all the same idea that I've laid out here, so you shouldn't be missing any information to get started on all of your other settings tweaks. So, I hope you learned something. Have fun. Good luck. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day. Tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes, ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gentle that when she passes, each one she passes goes, but I watch her so sadly. How can I tell her I love her? Yes, I would give my heart gladly, but each day when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at me. Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes I smile, but she doesn't see, doesn't see. Balotico is on my linda, my cheia de graça, ela menina que vem te passa, num dos balanços caminho do mar. Moça do cor dourado, do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado parece um poema, é a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar.